Hi everyone and welcome to my video. Today's video is an unexpected review because I have already returned all of the goodies that I bought from these two brands. So I wasn't going to do a video on these items, but I just really wanted to talk about them with someone. And I thought, who better than you guys? Hopefully some of you will find this useful. So let's get started. The first item that I want to talk about is the Benedetta Brusicius bag. I will refer to it as the Benedetta bag simply because I don't want to butcher the designer's name. So let's just keep it clean. The Benedetta bag. Now, this is not the first sparkling bag that I've had my eye on. Another one that I loved is by Prada, and it's like this very little tote, but it's also covered in sparkle. And the other one that I love is actually by Alexander Wang, and it's like this little pouch that is fully crystallized as well. The problem with both of these bags is that they can be only worn as top handle bags. I wanted a hands-free option, something a little bit more practical, something more versatile. So one day I received a notification from Luisa Villaroma that currently they have an offer that for an hour all full-priced items are 40% off. Some brands are unfortunately always excluded. So I went to see which bags do they have available with the discount. That's when I noticed this beautiful sparkly dream bag. The first thing that I immediately saw was that it has great size, which means it would fit all of my essentials. Another thing that I loved is that it's a shoulder bag. That means that I can be hands-free. It really reminds me of the old Fendi baguettes, but it is all crystallized. The next thing that I noticed was the price. And the price originally was just under 1,000 euros, but with the discount, including shipping, it was, I think, 590 euros, which is a great price for a designer bag. Another thing that I loved about this bag is that it's a slouchy bag. That means that it's going to be much easier to pull it off and wear casually. And finally, what convinced me to buy this bag is that it's a unique bag and it's not a very mainstream bag. You know, you don't see it all over Instagram. Of course, later on, I actually realized that this bag caused quite the social media frenzy. I don't know how I missed that because I feel like I'm usually on top of what's trending. I follow so many influencers and so many personal shoppers. So I feel like I'm pretty confident with all the trends, but somehow I have missed this bag. And even though it was a trending bag, not a lot of people still have it. So that's another thing that I really, really love. Just a few days later, I received this beautiful bag. First of all, I want to talk a little bit about the packaging. So the bag arrived in this pearly blush pink box, and it has a ribbon kind of built inside of the box, which I found kind of cool. So you can't really ever remove the ribbon. And anytime you want to put your bag inside the box, you can beautifully tie the ribbon once again, and it's going to look like it just arrived. The box opens like a shoebox. It doesn't have a magnetic closure, so that's a thing that I don't really like, but I mean, it's not also a very big deal. Okay, so now let's talk about the bag. It sparkles like a dream. If it's daytime, if it's nighttime, if you have a flashlight, if you don't have a flashlight, sun, no sun, this bag sparkles. There's also a bit of sparkle on the inside of the flap, so I found that cute as well. When I opened the flap, I actually saw a pleasant surprise. This bag has gold hardware, so that's another huge pro for me. Even though you can't really see it when you wear the bag, I love when there's a bit of gold. The zipper was smooth like butter. You could immediately tell that it is very, very high quality. The bag is also lined with 100% silk in this beautiful kind of champagne nude / blush pink color. The bag also has two pockets on the inside. I don't think that I would be personally using them, but you could put some coins there, possibly even a card holder. And now I want to talk about the styling of this bag. Guys, there are so many ways to style this bag. Very quickly, I actually took a couple of screenshots with styling ideas for this bag, and I just want to show you how easy it is to style this bag, and that this bag is definitely not only for special occasions or black tie events. You can definitely very easily wear this bag casually. So as an example, I have black jeans, black boots, and a sweater. Add this bag, it's a look. I also really love how a sparkly bag looks with denim. So in this case, let's take a nice blue denim dress and add the bag, it's a look. An outfit that is probably not for everybody, but I personally love, is wearing a sweatshirt and sweatpants with a designer bag. I love the contrast of something this basic and this simple and something so dressy. It's very kind of it girl and celebrity. The next outfit is a plain white t-shirt with mom jeans. Add the bag and off you go. You can go to a lunch date and you can go to a red carpet event. The bag gives you unlimited possibilities with the most basic outfits. Another simple yet effective look is a black dress. For example, something like I'm wearing today. This is a black blazer dress, but you can wear it with any casual black dress. Add a pair of boots, pop the bag on, so cute. If you want a more dressy look, you can also wear this bag with a suit. Literally any color suit. Wear it with a pair of heels for a more dressy look, or with a pair of sneakers for a more casual look. Since Christmas is coming and it is a very sparkly bag, you can also definitely wear it with a knit dress. Especially, I love how it looks with a cream knit dress and this bag. So cute. Another very basic and casual outfit is a black turtleneck with jeans. Add the bag, and again, so simple yet effective. One of the combinations that I didn't expect this bag would look great with is a pinstripe blazer. Add black jeans, and again, such a great look. So simple, but so good. And finally, I also love how it looks with shirt dresses. In this case, I can see a white shirt dress with this bag. Such a casual but effective look. As I said, this bag requires very, very little effort to look amazing. Daytime, nighttime, summertime, wintertime. You can literally wear it all year round, no matter the season. So now that I have been praising this bag for like 15 minutes, why would I ever send it back? There was one huge problem with the bag, and it's the fact that it was so, so delicate. Whenever I buy a luxury designer bag or any luxury designer item, I buy it as a forever piece. I want to know that I'll be able to wear this in a year, in 5 years, in 10 years, maybe even for longer, because I am spending a lot of money. So I want to be sure that I'll be able to wear it year after year. And this was simply not the case. Some of the crystals had already deformed a little bit. I mean, I understand because the bag is handmade, so there could be some flaws to it, but if it already arrived with flaws, how is it going to look after 1 year? And another huge problem that I found was that the silk on the inside of the bag had already been pulled a little bit. You know, like these little threads that come out of the fabric when you pull or rub some crystals on it? That had happened already without me even wearing the bag. So imagine, first of all, what is it going to do to the silk lining on the insides of the bag after a year? How is it going to look like? Probably very ripped apart. And think about it, if the bag is literally ripping itself apart, what is it going to do to my clothes? All of my knitwear, all of my silk dresses, even the most basic shirts, they could literally be destroyed because of the crystals. So as much as I love this bag, and as much as I wanted to keep it no matter what, because I think that it is such a beautiful statement piece to keep for forever, I realized that I won't be able to keep it for forever. I would wear this bag out within a year. I am telling you. After a year, this bag would look very, very bad. So I'm back where I started. I am still looking for that one perfect casual crystal bag. Okay, so we have reached the second part of the video, and now I want to talk about one of the most hyped brands of the year, Pangaea. I don't know, again, if I am pronouncing this correctly. If I'm not, please let me know in the comment section below of how it's supposed to be pronounced. So if you haven't heard of these guys, they are super environmentally friendly. They basically make bio-based sweatpants and sweatshirts and hoodies, very kind of casual outfits from recycled fibers and botanical dyes. Additionally to all of that, they also plant a tree in your name. So when I say that they are very environmentally friendly, they are very environmentally friendly. I have to be honest, this is one of those items that I bought because of social media. I saw it everywhere, so I felt like I'm supposed to be buying this as well, you know, because I am into luxury fashion. I also love environmentally friendly companies and businesses, so I have to buy from them. So I did. First, I want to talk a little bit about the packaging. You know me, I always need to comment on the packaging. The items arrived in a cardboard box, obviously, and they were packaged in these individual kind of string bags. I don't know how you call them. I call them string bags. Now, this was something cool and not cool at the same time, because I definitely prefer a cotton bag instead of plastic, but at the same time, I don't have any purpose of this string bag. I am definitely not going to keep my sweatpants in a dust bag. I mean, if I have to keep every single one of my sweatpants in a dust bag within a month, I would go insane, because that's just way too much organizing. And if I don't use this dust bag / string bag for my sweatpants, for what am I going to be using this bag? Nothing. I have so many of these bags because I've gotten them from many conferences that I've gone to, and I literally have no purpose for them. If you do have a use for them, that's absolutely great. You will be able to utilize this packaging. But in my case, I already know that this is going to end up in the trash. So I would actually prefer if it was packaged either in more paper or wouldn't have any packaging at all. Okay, so now let's talk about the fit. All of the clothes they make are unisex, and I haven't had really good experience with unisex clothing, but everyone said, every single video, every single review said, you should size down. So I did. I would normally buy a size large because I like really oversized hoodies and really, really oversized sweatpants. I sized down to size medium. And what do you think? Since I do have thick thighs, size medium for the sweatpants did not fit me at all. I really wish that I had gotten size large. And that's the thing about unisex clothing. It doesn't suit people with curves. And that's just my experience with unisex clothing. The hoodie, however, fit me very well. So if I were to order from them ever again, I would definitely have my hoodie in size medium and the joggers in size large. The next thing that I want to mention is that I ordered from the lightweight collection. They have three collections. One is the lightweight, then they have the original and also the heavyweight. The material was actually okay. It wasn't soft at all. So if you're expecting something soft, this is not going to be for you. But that didn't bother me as much as the fact that they were so transparent. When I put on the trousers, you could literally see the pocket. And I hate that about sweatpants. I hate it when you put on your sweatpants and you can see the pocket. It annoys me so much. I don't know if this is something that is very particular to the lightweight collection. It could be, but I hated it. I hated seeing that pocket. And another thing that I forgot to mention about the fit of the joggers is that they felt quite short. I mean, I am pretty tall. I am 5'9", but I am also not that tall. These are unisex clothes. Once again, I remind you that these are unisex clothes. So imagine that you're a guy who's 6'2". Those sweatpants are going to look ridiculous on you. So that's also a weird little thing that I found. I wasn't a fan of this set at all, so clearly I returned it. I am curious to try their heavyweight collection, but I have to be very honest and transparent with you guys. I'm all about honesty on this channel. And the last thing that I want to mention is the price. I had actually pre-ordered mine like months ago. On their website, it actually says that they only start making your order when you have paid for it. So for example, the production starts on the 5th of December and you're going to receive your goodies on the 5th of January. So that's how I got mine, and I had actually forgotten that I had paid 240 something euros for a pair of sweatpants and a hoodie, simply because it had caused such a social media frenzy and everyone had it. I had to buy it. So I had bought such expensive sweatpants and a hoodie. And let me tell you, I love the environment, but I can support the environment in so many other different ways than buying new overpriced hoodies and sweatpants. I'm telling you guys, I have to be honest, it felt really good having my 240 something euros back on my bank account instead of having these sweatpants. So that is just my experience. I truly wish them good luck, and they're becoming this huge brand, so it's very possible that after a couple of years or even possibly months, I might buy something from them once again, but as of this moment, the lightweight collection is definitely a hard no. So there you go, guys. I hope that you enjoyed this video and I hope that you found it useful. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel because I do love talking about fashion. So let's stay in touch and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys, stay safe.